make sense to really get it. I'm ready to get into the chicken. That JT finger lick the chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey yo, Nike check. T-shirt check. Sneakers check. Socks check. Hoodie check. Shorts check. Nike, I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. The shorty got a man, but she's saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Get the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all, my wrist going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. Going up sky high while I'm rocking Air Force. She just wanna ride, shorty bad and gorgeous. Rocky stripes, said it's alright. Then I cut her off, shorty stepped on my off-whites. Okay, now wait. Gotta get the bag in racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'ma say. Got a new press, those and a J's in the way. Got a new wrist watch, ready, don't take time. I fell up on the off if it's up too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock. I done made about a million and I'm only 19. Icy, water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she's saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it.
On the truck, I had a dream and it's stuck. Living my life cause we up, looking back like where the love. So I be hella low key, but contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turned me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately I've been scheming against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, but how you gonna act?
I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now I get it to go.
Ain't it crazy how them tables turn? You can fold or you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch him hate, watch him lurk. Can't relate, watch you stir. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters, in the murks, at the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight, set the bar, take flight. Yeah, I been grinding since I'm young and they told me my timing was coming. I been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame, get the money. I'm out in LA where it's sunny. I been eating since I'm young and since we ain't have food in our tummy. The life we was living ain't funny, but you cannot take nothing from me. Put that on my mama, my daughter, my cousin, my brother, I showed. Way better than I can tell you. The type of dreams that they sell you. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I'll see it later. To keep it real, you don't need to wait up. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State in TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. A few minutes prior to us coming on air, this crowd was jolted into action with the introduction of these Jaguars. They're set for football as the Jags are ready to match up with the Indianapolis Colts. Time for a much-needed and much-welcome diversion. The NFL is back. Here we go, week one. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. A man who played college football here in the Sunshine State. It's USF's Marlon Mack. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
And a yard at the 34-yard line.
Think a penalty here for a delay? No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, 2nd and 1 yard from the 34. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They fake the give. Now Wentz. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
But just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. From the gun, it's Wentz. And that is incomplete.
And that's exactly what defenses talk about. You've got to find ways to get off the field when you can, especially on 3rd down. And 3rd down defense going to be vital in this game. Able to knock that one away and force a 4th down.
And Sanchez on to punt here as he sends this one away. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
And they'll run it. This is James Robinson. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6.
Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
4 at the 26-yard line.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. On the run, it's Robinson. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On 3rd down, it's Robinson. Jags 1st down, at least at first glance, as he'll spot the football just beyond the marker. They find a way to convert on 3rd and inches. So after 2 first downs, they get another here. 1st and 10 at the 45. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. The catch made by James O'Shaughnessy to tight end. And he'll be taken down, but first he gets deep into Indianapolis territory. The big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards.
Running their plays over and over during the week can often get robotic for an offense, but on game day they can often flow smoothly, as that one just did.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 10 more there and another first down.
Move those chains. That's good for another Jackson.
They run. Robinson. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. We're getting close to the end zone, and you know that rookie wants the ball back. He's looking for his first career touchdown.
He certainly is, and you just wonder with the coaching staff, is it trust in him this early? Are they trying to get him going, give him confidence early in his NFL career? Either way, they want him to score.
And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being
thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked by the rookie Julian Blackman. And they'll have the football, but deep in their own territory as he's brought down at the 5. That's not one that he's going to want to remember, but he had to get it out of the way at some point, his first career interception.
And if he's the guy that they think he is, he's not laughing it off, but he's also not going to let it affect him as the game proceeds. He's going to go back out there, still be the same confident kid, the reason that they drafted him, and go out and play.
They begin the drive on the ground with Mack. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 6-yard line.
We're scoreless after one.
With no score.
Start of the second quarter, and it's the Colts in possession as they've got it with a second and 10. Shotgun now for Wentz. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. And he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Wentz now on first down. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. A gain of 11 that time and a Colts first down. Now a play fake. Wentz. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
On third down. Got an open man. That's Campbell. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards. Not really any offense for them to speak of here in this first half. Maybe that's what they needed, that big play.
Yeah, and it seems that maybe everything changes right there. They've been a little slow out of the gate. We've seen that. But that one big play, that could spark a big burst right here.
And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
First down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Marlon Mack. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
On second and 11 now. Wentz flush to his right. He'll find Hines out of the backfield. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. Flushed out right. And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. T.Y. Hilton there to make the grab as his guys are first onto the scene this afternoon. So he scrambled right, but was able to look back toward the middle of the end zone to find the target.
As you know, in this game, sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules, because we all know most guys throwing the football are taught never throw back into the middle of the field on a scramble. He did it and got away with it for a touchdown.
Instinct sometimes, right? They just take over.
Instinct and vision. Sometimes you just see people who are open, you're able to get it to them.
Just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing. You think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. They'll run it now with Robinson. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. A play-action fake. They'll look to throw. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked by the rookie Julian Blackman. And he'll bring it all the way back just a yard or two shy of midfield. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates going to check on it. Because
nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Jags grab it. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. And maybe that one caused by the weather. Of course, the rain coming down. Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Corey Willis. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
So his struggles just continuing here in the first half, throwing the football, Charles. Now three interceptions.
And they don't feel like they're just great plays by the defense. There's a sense that maybe he's a little careless with the football now. So some of the great coaches in the past, you know, they've always said, I can't teach you, obviously, because you're not listening. So maybe the bench can teach you. He's got to be careful now. He might get pulled.
From the 22, Wentz. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. He was looking for his running back, Nyheim Hines. And it's third down. From the gun, Wentz. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Carson Wentz with two first half touchdown passes. And the Colts are able to grow their lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
Pay attention. At their own 18-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
And that's caught. It's the tight end, Tyler Davis.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
At their own 22-yard line.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's got his tight end, O'Shaughnessy. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Kenny Moore. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now Blankenship on for the PAT.
And it is now 21-0.
Makes the score Colts 21. Jaguars nothing. Rodrigo Blankenship to kick off for Indianapolis.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
And this carries into the end zone. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount
Here's his opportunity.
It all comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? Rookie quarterback, rookie running back. They team up there to pick up the first.
And his throw is incomplete.
DJ Chark, first-time Pro Bowler, the intended receiver.
And that'll bring up second down.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
1 yard gain brings up second and nine.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And now here is another interception. It's Ha-Ha Clinton-Dix with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, five interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
On second down now, it's Mack. And he will lose yardage here back to his own six. This will be a loss of three and now a much tougher third down looming. Now Wentz on the bootleg. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane. And they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure. And to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it? Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the linebacker, Avery Williamson.
Those INTs all sting when you throw one in the red zone. I think especially as a rookie, maybe it stings a little bit more.
I think what you're saying is they don't all count the same, do they? Mm-hmm. Right? Interceptions in the red zone that you've given up points now, those are precious. So you have to learn from those and in a hurry.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. He's got his target. That's Zach Pascal. And he gets it to the 30 when it's all said and done.
And they were backed up to start the drive, but not anymore. Now, that's the play call that the offensive coordinator had in his head. You saw the end result. He wanted to go ahead and push the ball downfield, and that's what they did. And they wound up with good yardage there to get things rolling.
They'll run on first down with Marlon Mack. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of five. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40.
Good pickup there by Marlon Mack, and he was a 1,000-yard runner in 2019 and has been very consistent in moving the ball for the Colts. Last two seasons, at least 8 touchdowns rushing each year.
On play action, it's Wentz.
And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Brings up second and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. Way forward to the 48. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And whatever promise they showed in the preseason has not translated into week one because they have not been particularly competitive here. At home, no less. These fans just kind of beside themselves right now. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. Back to throw here. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6 at the 35-yard line.
He's got a man. It's his fullback. And out across midfield, down to the 45. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
They'll run here with Robinson. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first. The shotgun, he'll look to throw, and now here is another interception picked by the rookie Julian Blackman, and the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8.
At the 37-yard line.
Is Wentz into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted, picked up by the linebacker Miles Jack, and they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. So they get the takeaway, but that's just step one. They still have a lot of work to do,
but they don't want to focus on that now. Now it's about getting the ball in the end zone and hoping they can take it away again.
Yeah, still 3-score game though, fourth quarter. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Second and 2 at the 50-yard line.
And Jones has it over the middle. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Here we go on second and 12.
At the 23-yard line.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Marvin Jones there to make the grab. And the Jaguars get a score closer. It's up, it's good, and that'll cut the lead to 21-7.
That's the score, Colts 21, Jaguars 7.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get your reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. On play action, Wentz. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. The play began back at the 23, and they pick up 23. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield.
The ball carrier.
And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
It's now second and 6. Their 49-yard line.
Wentz to throw. Looking deep for Hilton. This is caught inside the 15. Yeah, this will get him all the way inside of Jacksonville's 10. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. They'll run here with Mack. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. Turning into a really good performance on the road. Week one, you're just hoping for that first win. It's tough to do it away from home, though, but they're looking strong.
It certainly is. Any road win in the NFL is a great road win. I mean, it just does not matter whether it's supposed to be tough or not. In this particular situation, how great will they feel leaving with a win on the road against a tough opponent?
A little work still to do, though. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. On first down, he'll drop to throw. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Xavier Rhodes, the cornerback, there in coverage. Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. And my goodness, another interception picked by the rookie Julian Blackman. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line.
On that boy stepping up by
it. Take over first and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Now wins. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. So this one winds up an Indianapolis victory. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for the Colts, hey, you get a win, you get it on the road. You can't ask for much more than that to start the year. And they will head home next week to take on the Minnesota Vikings. Meanwhile, for Jacksonville, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll try to rebound next week on the road in Nashville.
So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.